Everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Aiden, playing God of War Ragnarok. Let's continue the game. Let's continue the game. So we are going back to Midgard. I'd like to find something. Yes, let's do that. Across the realm. Let's do that.
Why doesn't Thor look like he did in that statue we saw in the lake? Back when it was still a lake.
It did at first. Then Thor saw it. The second sculpture was a great deal more complimentary.
Guess that explains why Odin's statue.
Okay, yeah, I
don't like an island.
I am what this game trying to do with me. There you go.
Finish the story.
Gladly. It was said that Yari and Somer first shared a kiss in the fields of Jotunheim.
Wait, what? How did they get there?
Don't know. Point is, they went on countless expeditions. Each location more beautiful than the last. But they found as they did, the destination became less important than simply traveling together.
What about the unnameable thing?
It was home. Yari and Somar had found it in each other.
That was beautiful. Okay, that was beautiful. Then let's go back. Yay. I am looking for something.
I got the sense Vanaheim wasn't supposed to be so human.
Something, yeah?
Is that the effect of Fimbulwinter there?
To a great extent, it seems.
So Midgard had endless night and cold. Svartalfheim had earthquakes. Alfheim had the light randomly pulsing. But Asgard didn't seem to be having any effects at all.
Odin had a long time to prepare.
No change I noticed in Helheim or Muspelheim either. Now that I think of it, the more primordial realms might be less susceptible.
How do you suppose Jotunheim is faring?
How would I know?
Just training your powers of speculation.
I don't know. Nobody's there to see. Does it even matter?
Here it is.
I can't believe Baldur's dragon is still here. It looks like it landed only yesterday.
Aye, cold preserved it. You've come quite a way since then, lad.
Thanks.
Okay, that was nothing. Oh, I see. We are doing this. Haha. Okay, it was not here either. Perhaps here. Oh, there.
Behind you, incoming.
Help them!
Yet still, that is not what I was looking for. It is not what I'm looking for. I have to go and search more. There's something else. Yeah, perhaps this is. Perhaps this is what I want.
That relic. Do you suppose it's the one we read about? Something to counteract a sleeping curse. Welcome.
Ha ha ha. And that's it. Okay. Okay, that's fine. I like that. I like that. It was beautiful. Ah! awakens something dormant deep down inside of Barrier. Okay, that's cool. Ooh, summon Jotunheim Essence. Is this a Christmas gift or what? Okay, let's head back. Let's head back to Sindri's and after that continuing the mission. Oh, hold on. Right? Nope. Not right. There has to be a gateway near. Okay. Let's go this way. Let's go there. There.
To tell you, I read something in Odin's library about what Galahorn is supposed to do. God, it sounds through all the realms and harmonizes. Well, it's somewhere like Tyr's temple, and it would be like opening up all the realm travel towers at once.
It's quite a vulnerability. Wonder why he didn't just destroy it.
Some artifacts defy destruction.
Well, we should make Freya aware of this.
Time and drop off your lean worm. Why must you make me repeat myself?
Master Kratos, thank you for coming. Much to discuss.
Speak.
The tree has become rather overgrown.
And?
And if it grows too wildly, the branches risk getting too heavy and falling, which is not ideal considering they hold all the realms.
I am no gardener.
What an absolute shock. No, I do not require any horticultural skills from you, but I would ask that you keep an eye open for the stags of the four seasons. They normally graze upon the tree and keep it tidy. Unfortunately, Bitter decided it would be funny to trick Arrogant into releasing them. If you happen to find the stags during your travels, I would greatly appreciate assistance in bringing them home. I would have one of my spectral squirrels do it, but they, well, keep eating the feed I give them.
Consequence of it being the most delicious food in all the Nine Realms, I suppose.
We have seen these stags.
Great. Then all you need is some feed. Once you've found a stag, the feed should calm them down. Then one of my spectrals will guide them back here. And, don't eat the feed, please.
I will not.
Vigilus asked me if I was too chicken to release them. But I am, in fact, not chicken-like whatsoever. So as you can see, I had no choice.
Yes, of course. What else could you have done? While normally this would be a harmless prank, Fimbulwinter prevented the stags from returning, and now they have long since scattered to parts unknown.
It was worth it.
Now then, any luck finding those lean worms?
So, this whole spectral squirrel business, you can shoot out your feelings into little ghosties.
I suppose that is a slightly inelegant way of putting it. These spectral versions of myself are aspects of my personality that I often find distracting at best. My ability not only lets me cast them away and provide some temporary peace of mind, it also allows me to see what goes on outside the tree.
Why not just go look yourself?
As the eternal caretaker of the tree, I may not leave its confines. All part of the deal, but worth it for the immortality and such. My spectral form still allow me to see the outside world, albeit through slightly colorful viewpoints.
That's one word for it. That bitter form of yours is a nasty piece of work.
I'm standing right here, you know-lit freak.
I'd apologize for him, but where would it end? I think that's
Here's
the long and short of it. Safe travels.
What a rambunctious bunch.